Welcome back to Tectonic Shift. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to retrieve pull requests from Azure DevOps using PowerShell. First, we will create personal access token with read permissions. Then we will get Azure DevOps project ID. After that, we will learn to get Azure repo ID. In last, we will get pull requests of the required repository within a specific date range using the Azure DevOps REST API. So let's get started. First of all, sign in your Azure DevOps account and at the top right corner, click the small settings icon and in the drop-down menu, click Personal Access Token. A new Personal Access Token creation page will open. Click this big blue button of New Token. Name your token something like Read Access REST API to make it understandable in the future. Setting expiry is up to you. I'm going with the default settings of 30 days. Now this is important. We need specific read access to get pull requests and project data via Azure DevOps REST API. So select Read Code Access option, then Project and Team Read Access. And last but not least, User Profile Read Access checkbox. At the end, click Create button, copy the token code to the clipboard and save it securely somewhere as we will be using it in our PowerShell scripts. Now, we will use this access token to retrieve the data via Azure DevOps REST API. I have placed all scripts under this Tectonic Shift GitHub repository. You can clone this repo to get all of them. I will paste the repository URL in the description section of this video as well. We will use three different scripts to achieve our goal. First of all, open GET Project ID script. This script will get all projects of the Azure DevOps organization with their respective IDs. So simply update PAT and run this script. Let's wait for the script to generate the output. As we can see, it has given all three projects I have in Tectonic Shift organization. We need Demo Agile Project ID for this demo. Let's copy its ID. Now, open GET Repo ID script and paste the project ID from the previous script output here to get all repositories under this project with their respective IDs. Of course, you will also need to paste PAT here as well, otherwise script will not work. Now, if we run this PowerShell script, this will give us output like this. So we have two repositories under the project ID we have given. We need Demo Agile Project repository ID, so let's copy its ID here. Now we will move to the final and interesting part of the video. Open Get Pull Requests by Date PowerShell script. Here we will paste the same organization name, our project ID, repository ID, and PAT of course. And then we will try to run the script. So after updating all variables, I have just ran the script. Here you can see that it has finally retrieved the pull request data in JSON format. We can manipulate it and use it for any fruitful cause. So you can see that it has retrieved the data successfully in the given date range. As I only have one pull request in the repository, it has given the count as one. You can see the status, title, who has created it, and creation date. Now let's understand this script a little bit. After getting all base variables, script also needs start date and end date. Just replace the date range as per your need. Script will only retrieve the pull requests under this range. Script manipulates the REST API URI. You can see Azure DevOps REST API documentation for more parameters and methods. You can use as per your need. I will paste the link in the description as well. So after getting the complete URI, script tries to get the response and on success, it simply prints the relevant information we have added to it. I have added this raw JSON intentionally so that we should have idea that which information we want and then add that information into the right output list. That's all for today. Please write in the comment section if you still have questions or queries. See you soon again. Until then, bye-bye.